Today, we will discuss about one of the Nepal's national pride projects, that is Bheri-Babai Diversion Multipurpose Project. It is a multi-basin irrigation cum hydropower project lying in Banke and Bardiya districts of western Nepal. What was the reason behind the construction of this project? During the study of Karnali and Mahakali conducted by JICA in 1992 AD, JICA considered Bheri-Babai Diversion Project as a priority project for hydropower development in Karnali Basin. Later, in 1998, JICA further carried out a study at feasibility level. From the study, it was found that the Bheri River is water surplus river, whereas the Babai River is water deficit river. The water level in the Babai River is low considering the area covered by the structure built for irrigation. So, it was decided to divert the water from Bheri River to Babai River to irrigate 51,000 hectares cultivation land in Banke and Bardiya districts. The elevation difference between intake and irrigation area is about 152 meters, which will help to generate 46.8 megawatt of electricity. In this way, it became multi-purpose project. What is the progress of this project till now? The project consists of three phases. First phase includes construction of 12.2 kilometer long tunnel. Second phase includes generation of electricity, and third phase includes irrigation of land and construction of agricultural road covering 125 km from Goreta to Ghatgaon. The construction of project was started in 2015. The construction of tunnel was taken by China Overseas Engineering Group Company. At first, conventional method was used to construct the tunnel of 4.2 meter diameter. Drilling and blasting works were done up to 150 meter long starting portal, which took almost 5 months to complete. Geologically, the project area lies in the region occupied by the rocks of Shivalik group with the overburden above this. Construction of tunnel of this size in such geological formation itself is a challenging task. Considering the technical difficulties in the construction of tunnel with the application of prevailing technology of drill and blast method, it has been decided to use tunnel boring machine TBM to construct the tunnel. It was the first project to use TBM technology or mechanized tunneling in Nepal. TBM method was chosen due to the faster mobilization and advanced rate offered by the mechanized mining. TBM can bore up to 25 meters per day in average. Due to the use of TBM, the first phase of the project was completed almost a year ahead of schedule. For the second phase, the contract agreement was signed with Raman Guangdong JV for 6.1 billion rupees in 2019. To divert the water from Bheri River to Babai River, 114 meter long and 15 meter tall dam is being constructed at Chiple in Surkhet. The main purpose of the project is to utilize the water in Bheri River. As we know that Bheri River is a water surplus river whose minimum available discharge is 80 cubic and the design discharge is taken as 40 cubic, which is half of the available discharge, which means assured water and power would be available practically throughout the year. The water will be diverted to start Babai River through the dam. For hydropower plant, surge shaft and powerhouse will be constructed at Untitled Bardiya. What are the challenges faced by the project? The strong point of this project is that there was no dispute in any of the issues, including land, tribunal, and investment during the construction of the project. But for such multi-purpose project, there is lack of sufficient skilled manpower in Nepal. And also, there were some technical difficulties faced by the project. On October 10, 2018, the rock grain shifted from perpendicular to almost parallel to the boring. The ground on the left-hand side was softer than the right, so it started to shift to the left. The alignment was shifted by around 131 mm, so the machine stuck in place. To get it moving, higher thrust of 18,500 kN was applied, but it did not move the machine. So, a bypass section of material was cleared out, and with a thrust of 10,000 kN, the machine resumed boring. This process took almost 5 days. There was another incident. 18 meters after the machine started boring again, the cutter head became clogged. High water flow mixed with loosely cemented sandstone dislodged the crown and jammed the cutter head. To overcome this problem, the water was completely stopped by injecting 1,287 kg of polyurethane through a 16-meter probe hole. Then, high cutter head torque was applied and the cutter head was able to dislodge and continue boring. These were the challenges faced during the first phase of the project. Despite of these challenges, first phase was completed ahead of schedule. The second phase of the project was running smoothly, but due to COVID pandemic, the pace of the project has slowed down. It is estimated that the project will be completed within 2023, with the cost estimated at 36.43 billion rupees. What are the benefits from this project? According to the project officials, the country will earn profit of 3.1 billion rupees from agriculture and 3.23 billion rupees from electricity annually after the completion of the project. Billions of rupees have been spent on the project to irrigate 51,000 hectares of land. Can the government secure the land for agricultural use without allowing it for plotting and housing? If you enjoyed this video and would like to get more from the Definitive Video channel for construction, subscribe to our channel, We the Influencer.